What are ticks? In this video we will learn a little bit about ticks, and how they look like in children. What are ticks? Ticks are movements, but not just any movements. They are rapid, sudden, recurrent, and non-rhythmic. There are two main types of ticks, motor ticks, just the movement, and vocal ticks. Motor ticks. Some of the motor tics are blinking, grimacing, jerking or banging head, clicking the fingers, walking in a specific pattern, for example kicking in the air every few steps, touching people and things. Vocal tics. Vocal tics are motor tics but involve using the nose or respiratory muscles. Vocal tics include sniffing, throat clearing, grunting, coughing, repeating words or phrases, stuttering-like symptoms, coprolalia. Coprolalia. Coprolalia involves involuntary outbursts of obscene or socially inappropriate words. It might be swearing, cursing, offensive remarks, references to genitals or excrement. They might also involve obscene gestures. These outbursts are not related to the situation, context or emotions when they happen. They are just uncontrollable. Why tics happen? Scientists and doctors don't know precisely why tics happen. Some of them claim that they have to do with the increased dopamine activity in the brain. They noticed that people present more tics when stressed, anxious, excited or even happy. How tics affect people? Tics may cause embarrassment and low esteem. A person with tics might be a victim of bullying and social isolation. Sometimes tics might cause pain or even accidental injury if the movements are violent. People also notice that tics get worse if you focus on them, point them out or try to suppress them intentionally. Who can be affected by tics? Anyone can be affected, but they often become more visible from 8 years of age and improve around puberty. First-hand experience taught me that it was the case for my child. Tourette syndrome. When tics become long-lasting or chronic and interfere with daily life, the person might have Tourette syndrome. To diagnose this neurodevelopmental condition, the person must have chronic tics for at least a year. They must be multiple and include at least one vocal tic. Tourette syndrome might be treated with medication, often antipsychotics or medication used for ADHD, or behavioral therapy. In an extreme case, brain surgery can be performed, and electrodes can be fitted. Treatment for tics. Tics, if mild, are not usually treated. If they affect the person's life or become chronic, medical treatment or therapy might be offered. On a different video, I will share with you 10 things you can do to help your child with tics. I hope this information is useful for you. Please let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Visit our website, allspecialneedsnow.com.